Hello everyone, Ojaswa Tyres Academy welcomes you in the series of MCQs based on daily current affairs. Today we will discuss the MCQs of 10 December, but before starting the video, you can download this PPT from the link given in the description box below. And second, as soon as you see question on the screen, please take a pause and try to answer it first and then see the explanation part so that you will be able to recall this MCQs during the real examination of UPSC 2020. So now, let's begin our MCQ. Now question number 1. It is regarding Blue Flag certification. First, it is an eco-label that is awarded to beaches and marinas that have qualified Sunset Global Standard. Second, India has no beach with Blue Flag certification in the present time. So here second is incorrect, first is correct. Hence answer will be A. Now let's check out the explanation part. So, Blue Flag certification is issued by an NGO, Foundation for Environmental Education, that is FEE, and has nearly 33 criteria to meet to obtain this certificate in 4 major areas, that is environment education, bathing water quality, environment conservation, safety and service in the beaches. And presently, the Chandrabhaga beach on Konark coast of Orissa became the first in Asia to get this certification in 2018. So currently, 12 Indian beaches are in the race to get the Blue Flag certification. An effort is made by Union Environment Ministry. So presently, Chandrabhaga beach has got this Blue Flag certification. So statement second was incorrect. Now let's move on to the next question. Now question number 2 is regarding torrefaction. First, it is a thermal process to convert biomass into biocoal. Second, the process is a great alternative to avoid stubble burning. Third, biocoal has higher sulfur content as compared to traditional coal. So third is incorrect, rest two are correct, hence answer will be A. Now let's check out the explanation part. And if the statement is given that torrefaction is a technology which is indigenous to India would be incorrect. So, do consider this kind of statement. It is a Swedish technology and it is a thermal process to convert rice stubble into bio coal. And the process can be of great advantage to avoid the stubble burning, which is a major problem during winter season, especially in Delhi area. And this bio coal produced by torrefaction is superior to traditional coal because it has lower sulfur and ash content, whereas calorification value is high. Here is the image given, and as compared to fresh biomass, the torrefied biocoal is a great alternative since it carries less storage space, less biological degradation and less greenhouse emission up to less than 95%, which is great advantage. Now let's move on to the next question. Now question number 3 is regarding Maestrika swamps. First, Maestrika swamps are located at the northeastern states of India. Statement second, they are the million-year-old tropical ecosystem that play a key environmental role and as carbon sink. So you have to choose the correct option. So statement second is correct, first is incorrect, hence answer will be B. Now let's check out the explanation part. So this is the image of Maestrika swamp, and they are fastest shrinking, fragmented and endangered ecosystem restricted to small patches, but they are found in southern Kerala, northeast Karnataka, Goa and recently discovered in northern east western ghats of Maharashtra. And these swamps are million-year-old tropical ecosystem which play a key role in maintaining a perennial stream flow owing to their ability to hold water all year round and carbon sink. And they are home to rich biodiversity. Now let's move to the next question. Now question number 4, you have to consider the following statement regarding cyclone Kamuri. First, the cyclone has hit the eastern coast of Pacific Ocean. Second, Kamuri or Pisoi is a tropical cyclone. So second statement is correct, first is incorrect, hence answer will be B. Now let's check out the explanation part. So Kamuri or Pisoi is a tropical cyclone. There is a difference between tropical cyclone and temperate cyclone. You consider about them. Temperate cyclone are different from tropical cyclone. This question could be asked. and that has hit the western coast of Pacific Ocean, causing series of winds and landfall in Philippines. Tropical cyclones form only over warm ocean water near the equator, and a tropical cyclone is a rapidly rotating storm system characterized by a low pressure center, a close low pressure atmospheric circulation, strong winds and a spiral arrangements of thunderstorm that produce heavy rain and landfall. And the capital of Philippines is Manila. And here's the map is given. Now let's move on to the next question. Now question number 5 is regarding Sudan, which was recently in news. First, it is a landlocked country located in Northeast Africa. Second, the capital Khartoum is located at the confluence of River White Nile and Blue Nile. Here, second is correct, first is incorrect, hence answer will be B. Now let's check out the explanation part. So statement first was incorrect because Sudan is not a landlocked as it is in the direction of northeast. Here you can see in the map, this is the Red Sea and it is the Sudan. It bordered with Egypt, Libya, Chad, Central African Republic, South Sudan, Ethiopia and Eritrea. Now let's move on to the next question. Now question number 6 is regarding the data tabled by Ministry of Jal Shakti regarding water quality. So first, arsenic is the most common contaminant of drinking water. Second, Rajasthan has the highest number of rural habitats affected by contamination of overall. Third, West Bengal has the highest number of rural habitats affected by arsenic contamination. Fourth, Assam has the highest number of rural habitats affected by iron contamination. So here, first is incorrect, rest are correct, hence answer will be D. Now let's move on to the explanation part. So statement first was incorrect because it has been found that iron is the most common contaminant in drinking water and it is followed by salinity, arsenic, chloride and heavy metal. Here you can see in the image, highest one is iron, then salinity, and the arsenic pollution is highest in West Bengal and iron pollution is highest in Assam. And the state and utilities that are not affected by any of this contamination are Andaman, Nicobar, Goa, Gujarat, Himachal Pradesh, Ladakh, Manipur, Mizoram, Nagaland, Puducherry, Sikkim and Tamil Nadu. So this is the additional information here. Now let's move to the next question. Now question number 7, it is regarding Narwhal, which was recently in news. First, it is a medium sized mysterious whale species. Second, it inhabits the freezing water of Arctic around Greenland, Canada and Russia. Third, it is the only whale that has a tusk. So here all the given statements are correct. So answer will be D because incorrect is asked. Now let's check out the explanation part. So this is the image of narwhal, which is the species of whale species, and this is the image where tusk is, you can see here. And narwhal tusk is the only one in the animal kingdom which is straight like a line. Here you can see. And the tusk has a spiral, the thread runs counterclockwise along its length and can be swiveled by the whale up to 12 degrees. So recently it was news, so this question might be asked in the UPSC examination. Now let's move on to the next question. Now question number 8 is regarding GST Council. First, it is a statutory body chaired by Union Finance Minister. Second, it makes recommendation on all important issues related to goods and service taxes. So your second is correct, but answer will be A because incorrect is R. First is incorrect here. Now let's check out why first statement is incorrect. So statement first is incorrect because GST Council is a constitution body, though it is headed by Finance Minister, but it is constitution body, not statutory. And the GST Council is now scheduled to meet on December 18th to focus on the revenue augmentation, and states are guaranteed compensation for any revenue shortfall below 14% growth for the first 5 years ending 2022 under the GST Act. And the GST compensation is paid every 2 months by the center to the state. And the slowing stream of both direct and indirect tax collection poses a great challenge for the government to meet its tax recipient targets set in the budget. Now let's move to the next question. Now question number 9 is, any questions regarding the age of High Court judges is decided by which of the following authority? So the correct answer is B, President. Now let's check out the explanation part. So option B is correct because Article 217 Clause 3 says that if any question arises as to the age of judge of High Court, the question shall be decided by President after consulting with Chief Justice of India, and the decision of President will be final. And at present, there are 24 High Courts in the country. Out of them, 4 are common High Courts. So try to find out which 4 are common High Courts. And the Delhi is the only UT that has a High Court of its own since 1966. And the other UTs fall under the jurisdiction of different state High Courts. And the Parliament can extend the jurisdiction of High Court to any Union Territory or exclude the jurisdiction of High Courts from any Union Territory. So remember where Parliament will come into the picture and where President will come into the picture. Now let's move on to the next question. Now question number 10 is, Nangarh province was recently in news. Where is this located? So the correct option is C, Afghanistan. Here you can see the location of Nangarh province in Afghanistan. It is nearby Pakistan and located in the eastern part of Afghanistan. So here I am wrapping up today's MCQs. Hope you guys are liking the lecture. And in the last, positive quotation is, the capacity to learn is a gift, the ability to learn is a skill, and the willingness to learn is a choice. To keep learning, work hard and be consistent, regularly watch our videos to enhance your knowledge. And please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates of the videos. Please like, comment and share the video. We will meet tomorrow with the next MCQs. Till then, keep studying. Thank you.